In April of 2007, at 9:32, an incredible building hosting brilliantly talented gymnasts burnt to the ground. With the amazing willpower of the coaches, gymnasts and community, they managed to raise the new Bury Gymnastics Club from the ashes. The arson attack had a harsh impact on the coaches and gymnasts to the point where they had to find alternative ways for them to train.
Gutted. Absolutely gutted. The parents had seen fire engines over at the gym, so we rushed across quick as we could. And when we got there, there was four fire engines and nothing left of the building, which was on, the 9th of April, I think it was. Me and my friend, who's been a colleague of mine for like 30 years, we just went down to the local pub and got a pint. We just looked at each other and he was left numb, completely numb with the devastation of what are we going to do next.
Luckily, all the gym clubs around about offered us places. My squad went down to Salford. Gary Reed, the coach at Salford, agreed to let us go and train there for nothing. And we're eternally grateful to him.
Well, they had to relocate. We had to find, obviously, temporary accommodation for them to train in. Obviously, everyone was just gutted, really, that someone could do it to the building.
It was a difficult time for both parents and coaches and the kids, you know, to be travelling, you know, as far as Stockport and over to Wigan, etc., into Manchester, Rochdale.
I remember my mum telling me that there was no gym and me asking why, and she's saying someone had burnt it down. It made me feel really sad and that I couldn't train anymore, and I thought we were going to have to quit gym altogether.
Well, I had to move to another gym for a while and then we moved back to Bury Bridge. The temporary gym didn't have any pits and the facility was quite basic and not much equipment.
I think it had quite a big impact on my training because I was training 3 or 4 times a week when at the time of the attack, and then to cut it down to 1 or 2 made quite a big impact on my training. I had to travel to Stockport Gym and CMIG in Manchester to train. Stockport probably took about 45 minutes each night to get there, and Manchester Gym's about half an hour away, so a longer distance than to come here.
We did lose a few. However, we did maintain quite a lot as well, because we had local schools within the Bury area, like Woodbank, for instance, who granted us a couple of hours each week so we could still run our gymnastics squads and classes.
With this devastating event, the community was determined to regain the facility back to the original grounds.
We did quite a lot of fundraising. I think we did like these charity bowls. We had charity bowls, we had a lot of putting money in Smarty tubes and things like that. As the bag of pack things. So this went on. We had quite a really good fundraising team, good committee, and I think this went on for about 3 years. And then we also got the Sport England money as well. So it was half and half. We raised half and then they contributed half as well. And I think we got a few grants. We applied for quite a few grants and that helped as well.
It was 5 years, and I think we opened virtually 5 years to the day we got burnt down. The old gym, which had 2 buildings, and in part of the building there was a trampoline and there was parallel bars. So we've still got some parallel bars, which we've had for a number of years, and a couple of pommel horses, but other than that, everything else was just wiped out. As you can see, the facility is fantastic. It's a state-of-the-art gymnastics facility, and it caters for all, you know, sport for all, including, you know, like I've said before, the preschool, going through all the infants, juniors and into seniors.
I really like the new gym because of the pits and we get to like train harder.
Well, they continue to develop. We've been in this new facility now for just 2 years, and you know, what we now provide, the number of extra gymnasts we can provide the training for. We have waiting lists that exceed 300 or 400 people wanting to come to the gym. and you know, the future is just to develop further to get gymnasts to national and international standard. Given the time frame over the last 5 or 6 years to deliver this, the morale is better than it's ever been now.
Thanks to the hard work of the community and Sport England funds, Bury Gymnastics Club was better than ever.
I train Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Sundays.
I train 24 hours a week.
I was about 4 when I started gym. I train Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Sunday. About 27 hours a week.
The new gym helped the gymnasts achieve their physical abilities and gain better flexibilities, balance, coordination and mental strength.
Gymnastics is great fun, but I think you've got to put a lot of work in, a lot of dedication, a lot of time spent in the gym, you know, sacrificing things, but in the end, to do things like Olympics, World Championships, it really does pay off. I think this gym's a lot bigger and better than the old gym, and it's got a lot better facilities than the old gym.
It's bigger, you've got more equipment, it's better to use.
I would definitely love to do gymnastics as a career. It's definitely the most fun sport you can do, and it's just enjoyable in general.